Students, good morning. Now the attendance I have sent to head office and also to your HOD, and the same thing it is given to your group. So here, according to this, roll number 14 has lowest attendance and it is 73.9. Adrita Pathak, roll number 20. Total classes 19 classes you have done out of 23. So maximum 100% attendance. Roll number 32 has attended 19 classes. Roll number 33 also 19 classes out of 23. So 82% attendance. So you can think, if I give internal marks according to this attendance, so maximum number of students are 100% attendance, and at 80% attendance, how many students? Let me count. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 students are 80% in attendance. One student from 70 to 80%. So 4 from 80 to 90. One from 70 to 80. That is the lowest attendance. And 95% attendance. Roll number 44, 45. Roll number 39, 91% attendance. Roll number 37, 95% attendance. Roll number 34, 87% attendance. Roll number 33, 82%. Roll number 32, 82%. So you can think. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33. So here, total number of students is 45, and 33 students, they have 100% attendance. So 12 students are less than 100. And starting from 70% to 90%. So you can think, 33 students has 100% attendance, and rest 12, it is less than 100, and the lowest one is 73.9. So you can judge, you will not get the same type of internal marks. So just, it is a reminder, every month it will be calculated, and if you are missing any class, then that will create problem for you who are not attending. So this is the attendance record, and according to that, yet the Google form I have not sent, but I will send the form and I will discuss to your parents also. Getting the phone number, I will phone first and I will keep one video conference, and there I will discuss why you are not attending the classes. And this is sent to your department, the attendance, and also sent to your head office. And now still 43 attendance. Again, 3 absent today. Again. So I am going to take strict step after this. Initially, at the starting of my of this semester, all were present. But now what is happening? Every day 2 to 3 students are absent. I'm not asking about those 33 students who have 100% attendance. The rest 12, that attendance is varying every day. And you will get the form, Google form, you will put it, you will fill up the form and you will give the attendance of your, you will give the information of your father's and mother's phone number and I will talk to them and then we'll arrange one video conference. So every day I'm warning you all, but that 12 students are not listening. Up to accepting today's class, total 23 classes I have taken. And out of that 23, if anyone is at 21, 22, then it may be okay. But that is 18 classes, 19 classes, 17 classes. This is not okay. Roll number 1.
Yes, ma'am.
2. 3.
Present, ma'am.
4.
Present, ma'am.
5.
Present, ma'am.
6. Okay, 6 present. 7.
Present, ma'am.
8.
Present, ma'am.
9. Roll number 9. 10.
Present, ma'am.
11. Roll number 11. Roll number 11. Absent. 12.
Present, ma'am.
13.
Present, ma'am.
14. 14 is present. 15.
Present, ma'am.
16.
Present, ma'am.
17.
Present, ma'am.
18.
Present, ma'am.
19.
Present, ma'am.
20.
Present, ma'am.
21.
Present, ma'am.
22.
Present, ma'am.
23.
Present, ma'am.
24.
Present, ma'am.
25.
Present, ma'am.
26. 27.
Present, ma'am.
28. Roll number 28. So absent 28. 29.
Present, ma'am.
30.
Present, ma'am.
31.
Present, ma'am.
32.
Present, ma'am.
33. Roll number 33.
Present, ma'am.
34. Roll number 34. Absent. 35.
Present, ma'am.
36.
Present, ma'am.
37.
Present, ma'am.
38.
Present, ma'am.
39.
Present, ma'am.
40.
Present, ma'am.
41.
Yes, ma'am.
42.
Yes, ma'am.
43.
Present, ma'am.
44.
Yes, ma'am.
45.
Yes, ma'am.
So, 3 students are absent today. 11, 28 and 34. ওকে দরজাটা বন্ধ করতে বলে ওইখানেই একটু বসে আছে। Now the total attendance is showing 44. Who is that extra student? Who came late? 11, 28 and 34. These were absent earlier. Who is the student? 11, 28
and 34. Ma'am, I'm 2 times joined.
Hum?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So in laser, what I discussed last day, I discussed the last topic, that was Einstein's AV coefficients and the relation among the Einstein AV coefficients, that is A21 by B12 equal to this, and or A21 and B21 was B12. So according to that, A21 by in place of B12, I have written B21. So that was discussed last day. I have already shared this PPT. So you will read it yourself, this portion, the advantages of the gas lasers and in comparison to solid state laser. That means gas laser and solid state laser. So gas laser means active medium is gas, and solid state laser means the active medium is solid. So helium neon laser and ruby laser I have already discussed. So these are the different applications of laser. Now coming to different problems. In a helium neon laser, transition from 3s to 2p level gives a laser emission of wavelength 332.8 nanometer. Nanometer means 10 to the power minus 9 meter. If the 2p level has energy equal to 15.2 into 10 to the power minus 19 joule, calculate the pumping energy required. Assume known loss. So this is the formula: pumping energy equal to energy of 2p level plus energy of photon. So the energy of 2p level is already given. Now we have to calculate h nu. And we know that nu equal to c by lambda. So this formula is c by lambda. So this plus this, this is h equal to Planck's constant. This is the value 6.62 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second. Then c is the velocity of light. This is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. And lambda, that is already given, 632.8 nanometer. Nanometer, if you convert it to centimeter, convert it into meter, then you have to multiply this with 10 to the power minus 9. So 632.8 into 10 to the power minus 9 meter. So if you calculate the final answer, you will get like this, 11.46 electron volt. Shonu? Now This is the problem. So the answer is 11.46 electron volt. This was given earlier in the frequently this question, particular question. Am I audible? Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
So this particular problem was frequently given in previous exams, in your semester exam. So this is the important problem. So mark it, this problem. Particular this problem. Find the energy difference between the two energy levels of neon atoms of a helium neon gas laser. The transition between these levels gives a light of wavelength 632.8 nanometer. Also calculate the number of photons emitted per second to give a power output of 2 milliwatt. The energy difference between the two energy levels of neon atoms, that is delta E, that is equal to hc by lambda. That is equal to 6.63 into 10 to the power minus 34. This is the value of H and this is the value of C divided by this lambda. So this is the value, this joule, this is in joule. And delta E equal to what? 3.143 into 10 to the power minus 19 divided by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. So it was initially in joule. Now it is converted to electron volt. So if we want to convert joule to electron volt, then we have to divide by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. So it is divided and now this is the finally we have this value. Now if n is the number of photons emitted per second to give a power output of 2 milliwatt, then P equal to what? N into delta E. So n equal to what? N equal to P by delta E. So this is 2 into 10 to the power minus 3 watt divided by delta E. That is 3.143 into 10 to the power minus 19 joule. So this is 6.363 into 10 to the power 15. So N is the number. So calculate the number of photons emitted per second to give a power output of 2 milliwatt. So this is the answer. This is the number. Next. Find the ratio of populations of the two states in thermal equilibrium at room temperature 27 degrees centigrade. The wavelength corresponding to the energy gap between two states is this. So already this formula was discussed. This is the Boltzmann, according to Boltzmann relation. The population of the higher energy state and the lower energy state, it is related by this equation. So check your earlier PPT. It is written there. N2 by N1 equal to the power minus delta E by KT. And delta equal to what? The difference between the energy levels E2 and E1. That is lower energy state and higher energy state, that energy difference. Now N2 by N1, that is equal to this. In place of delta E, I have written minus H nu. So minus delta E it was. Now minus H nu by KT. So ultimately now nu, I'm converting in the form of lambda. So e to the power minus HC by lambda KT. So if you put all the values, so T value is given, that is 27 degrees centigrade. Now if we want to convert in Kelvin, then what we have to do from centigrade to Kelvin? What we have to add?
Plus 273.
So in this way, you can find out the value of T. Already the value of lambda is given, 6000 angstrom. It is given, K is the Boltzmann constant. This value also you know. H value you know, C value you know. So if you put all the values, then e to the power minus this term you can calculate and the answer is 4.90 into 10 to the power minus 35. Now this is another problem. In a lasing process, the ratio of population of the two energy levels out of which upper one corresponds to metastable state. That is the ratio. This 1 is to 1.009 into 10 to the power 25. So it is the given. The ratio of population is given. So you can see here, N1 by N2 equal to 1 by this. That means 1 is to this thing. So the population ratio is given. Calculate the wavelength of the laser beam at 320 Kelvin. So already given the value N1 by N2 equal to this. From here you can calculate N2 by N1. And T is given. 320 K. Now we know the Boltzmann relation. So N2 by N1 equal to this. So already the ratio you know, N2 by N1. So put it here. So what you can calculate? K value, you know t value, you know. So what is the unknown thing? E2 minus E1, the difference between the two energy levels. So this is delta E. So from here you can calculate that difference of energy levels. And delta E you can calculate as 2.54 into 10 to the power minus 19 joule. So lambda B, if be the wavelength of the laser beam, then we know Hc by lambda. Actually, it is H nu equal to delta E. Delta E equal to H nu. Now, nu equal to C by lambda. So delta E equal to Hc by lambda. Now, lambda from here, you can calculate Hc by delta E. So Hc by delta E, H is the Planck's constant, C is the velocity of light, and delta E is the energy difference that you have already find out. So lambda, the answer is finally 783 into 10 to the power minus 9 meter. So if you just 10 to the power minus 9, so you can convert it to nanometer. So you will get 783 nanometers. So lambda, this is our desired wavelength. So the question was calculate the wavelength of the laser beam and 320K. It is lambda equal to 783 nanometer.
Ma'am, N2 by N1 equal to 10 to the power minus 25. Huh?
What? NY by
one,
N2?
1.009 into 10 to the power minus 25. Minus 25.
How? So minus it is denominator is this, no? N1 by N2. If you do N2 by N1, then what you will get? It is N1 by N2. Here it is N2 by N1.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Sorry, ma'am.
Oh, just wait. So, this is not actually, because N1 by N2 equal to 1 by this thing. Into 10 to the power minus 25. Oh, that.
So, it should be 10 to the power 25.
Mm-hmm. Actually, see, I have just take a snapshot from book. Okay. This is not written by me, these portions. So I always told you all that whenever you are following any book, there are several different printing mistakes. Okay. So this is from one book, probably from S.P. Quilla, this problem. So these are all the problems that you can see it is photocopy. Okay. And this these portions, that is my calculation. I have typed this portion, but this is I have taken from book. So these are different problems from different books. So from that I have collected. So maybe some problems in that book, and not only from for this notes. If you follow any book, so the procedure you know, and then calculate yourself. And at last, the answer may be same or also may not be same. It is given here lambda equal to 783, but it may not be same also. If so, you calculate yourself. Okay. So whatever may be mistake in between, so just find it out and calculate yourself. You know, so for this problem, what is important? Here important is this relation. The ratio is given already from the PPT. You know the Boltzmann relation between the populations of the two energy states. From there, you can find what you have to find out. You have to find out delta E. And from that delta, you will find out lambda. So these are the steps. So also, if you are getting any mistake, then maybe write. So these are the photocopy from the book. So do it yourself. Do the calculation, all the calculation yourself. Then you will get the right answer. Okay. And also in the last assignment, one problem was there that you all said that some problem mistake in the answer is given. So maybe that I have copied it from book and I have not calculated myself. So maybe some mistakes, but if you are all the students are getting the same type of answer, then that obviously that answer is book answer is wrong, and whatever you are getting that is right. If all of you are getting, so for that purpose, I have created this group, WhatsApp group. If you have any mistake in any PPT or any numerical, then just discuss in your group that this is the answer. So if everyone supports that it is the right answer, then that will be the right answer. Not in the PPT that is given, that is right. That is not right. Your answer is right. because all the things are not done by myself. Some problems I have taken from different books. So maybe mistakes in there, in these portions. Okay. Now problem number 5. So actually, this theory is not very important for you. So I have not discussed. But sometimes given this formula, I have given the note. And in that portion, it is given. So if possible, so did it yourself. And only the remember the formula, that is delta nu equal to C by 2L. And you know that is plane mirrors forming resonant cavity in Heliumneon laser are at a distance of 0.5 meters. So here L value is given. So what is delta nu? Find the modes of separation of longitudinal cavity. So directly use this formula. Only you remember this formula because sometimes in mathematical portion or numerical problems, it may be given, but this is not very important. The theory, that is the derivation, is not important. So actually the syllabus is very big, and you know that in optics, if you go through the syllabus, total 5 lectures are allotted for your optics. Total 5 lectures are allotted for your optics. But already I have 5 lectures in polarization, then 3 and today, including today, 4 lectures in this laser, then 5 plus 4, that is 9 lectures I have already taken. And diffraction is yet not completely started. So if I take 4 lectures in diffraction, so 9 plus 4, 13 lectures total I have to take. But it is allotted 5, only 5 lectures are allotted for optics. So you can think that I can't discuss in very... I have to discuss in brief, otherwise I can't complete my syllabus. So this is not very important, that the theory discussion of this portion. So remember only this one, delta nu equal to C by 12, if any numerical is given, so that you can calculate. So this where the this is the end of laser. Now I'm not discussing much about it. So everything I have completed about laser. Now the next one is diffraction. So this is the module 2, the diffraction in module 2 optics. So this is the first lecture of diffraction. Now, for to know diffraction, you have to know something, that is a wavefront. You have to need these ideas, the definitions. A wavefront is defined as the locus of all points which are at same state of vibration, that is in the same phase. So the wavefront is defined as the locus of all points which are in the same state of vibration. The shape of the wavefront depends on the shape of the light source. So here from this chart, you can see that wavefront may be spherical, wavefront may be cylindrical, and wavefront may be plane. Now, the shape of the wavefront depends on the shape of the light source. So, what is the light source? Depending on this, the wavefront shape depends. So, here you can see spherical wavefront. Spherical wavefront, say this is the point source. So, say this is the point source. You can see if the center in the of the circle, if the point source is here, then the wavefront for this point source will be spherical wavefront, and all the points, all the, that is the locus of all points. So this point on this circle, all the points on this circle. So this point, this point, this point, this point, in this way, all the points, they are in the same state of vibration. So point source, it emits wavefront of spherical in nature. Now cylindrical wavefront, cylindrical wavefront, this is the line source. You can show this line. You can, this is shown here, the line. The line, can you see this line? So this is the line source. So this is the line source. So this is not point source. The source is line. So this is the line source. Now, the shape here, cylindrical wavefront. So here you can see all the points here. Here, if you consider any point here, if you consider any point here, or if you consider any point here, all these points are in the same state of vibration. So if you consider these points, then you will get the shape of a cylinder. So this is the cylindrical wave front. And if the source has its infinity, now first one is point source, the wave front was spherical. This was line source, the wave front is cylindrical. And this is the source at infinity. The light is coming from infinity. Now that wave front you will get as plane wave front. So this is the concept of wave front. So wave front is defined as the locus of all the points which are in the same state of vibration. So locus of all the points, it is they are in same state of vibration. For point source, it is spherical. For line source, it is cylindrical. For the source at infinity, it is plane wave front. So in also in your syllabus, one experiment on laser, it is in your syllabus. So it may be, so laser, it is light. So everything you have to know about light and where light comes, and diffraction is also there. By the method of diffraction, you are getting laser diffraction method. You are calculating in that practical the wavelength of the laser light, that is in your syllabus. So you have to find out the wavelength of the laser light by the laser diffraction method. And there two terms are there. One is laser and another one is diffraction. So these portions are also important for your viva or for your practical purpose. So remember, wave front are three types: spherical, cylindrical, and plane. If point source is the source is point source, then it is spherical wave front, because here all the points, locus of all the points, are in the same state of vibration. Same state of vibration, that is in the same phase, are situated on the surface, that is of a sphere. So this is point source and spherical wave front. This is line source and cylindrical wave front. And this is source as infinity, that is plane wave front. Now diffraction. When waves encounter obstacles or openings, it may be obstacles or it may be openings, then they bend round the edge of the obstacles. If the dimension of the obstacles are comparable to the wavelength of the waves, then the bending of the waves around the edges of the obstacle is known as diffraction. So a diffraction means the bending of the light wave around the edges of the obstacle. If the dimension of the obstacle are comparable to the wavelength of the light wave. So this is the condition. If the dimension of the obstacle are comparable to the wavelength of the waves, the bending of the waves around the edges of the obstacles is known as diffraction. Interference is two separate waves from two coherent sources superposed at a point on the screen. And diffraction, secondary wavelets originating from different parts of the same wave front superposed. So in diffraction, secondary wavelets originating from different parts of the same wavefront superpose. The width of the interference fringes may or may not be equal, but the diffraction bands are never of equal width. All bright fringes have the same intensity, but in diffraction, the intensity of the bright band usually decreases with the increase of the order number. That you will see whenever you will do the experiment. Then you will see this, that intensity of the bright band usually decrease with the increase of the order number. And when we will discuss the theory, that will be proved why it decreases. All the dark fringes have zero intensity. In interference pattern, all the dark fringes have zero intensity, but the dark bands is not zero in diffraction. So this is the diffraction difference between interference and diffraction. This is a very important question. What are the difference between interference and diffraction? Now, classification of diffraction. The diffraction phenomena can be divided into main classes. First is Fresnel class of diffraction and another is Fraunhofer class of diffraction. So these are the two main thing about the diffraction. See here, two figures are given. Fresnel diffraction and Fraunhofer diffraction. So first come to Fresnel diffraction. In Fresnel class of diffraction, either source or light or the screen or both are at finite distance from the diffraction aperture or obstacle. So see here, either the source. So what is the source in this figure? Say S. So source of light is S, and the air or the screen. What is the screen? What is the name of the screen?
P.
So P is the screen. So what is given in Fresnel class of diffraction? Either the source or the screen, this screen or both are at finite distance from the diffraction aperture or obstacle. Diffraction aperture or obstacle. Here this is the aperture. So here this is the aperture. So this is aperture, and from this aperture this is the source and this is the screen. So either source or of light or the screen or both, either this S or this screen P or both S and P are at finite distance from the diffraction aperture. So here aperture is shown here. So from this diffraction aperture, so from this diffraction aperture, either S, either P or both are at finite distance. So you can measure the distance. So it is finite distance. So they are in finite distance. So this is the condition. The wavefront in Fresnel class of diffraction is either spherical or cylindrical. Remember this one. It is given. Classify the or classification of diffraction. They explain the classification of diffraction, or it may be given. Write down the difference between Fresnel class of diffraction and Fraunhofer class of diffraction. So what is the Fresnel class of diffraction? Either the source or the screen or both source and screen are finite distance from the aperture. Okay. So are at finite distance from the aperture. So from the source, light is coming here in this direction, and it is actually moving in this direction, and here we are getting the diffraction pattern. So this is the Fresnel class of diffraction. So this is actually diffraction is the bending of light. So light, it is by the diffraction, the light is going in this direction where we are getting the diffraction pattern. Now Fraunhofer class of diffraction, here source of light and the screen are effectively at infinite distance. So this is important about Fraunhofer class of diffraction. So the source of light, what is the source of light in the second figure? This is S. And what is the screen? This is P. They are at infinite distance from the diffraction aperture. So this is the diffraction aperture. It is shown here. So this is the diffraction aperture. The source of light and the screen, they are at infinite distance. Remember this one. This is very important about Fraunhofer diffraction. So how it is here? This from the source, it is coming to a lens. Then again passing, it is passing through this aperture, then by this lens it is then again converging and coming to this direction, and after passing through this lens the light is coming as parallel rays, and here for that reason we are assuming that source is at the light is coming from infinity, and after passing through this lens it is going in this direction. So this system I will discuss in Fraunhofer diffraction, the same thing I will discuss. So later, so Fraunhofer diffraction we are going to. So this is the intensity of a single slit diffraction, Fraunhofer diffraction, that I am going to discuss in detail later. So this system we will discuss later. So what is the basic difference? So anyone tell me what is the basic difference between Fraunhofer diffraction and Fresnel diffraction?
In Fresnel diffraction, the point of source and screen is finite distance from the aperture, and in Fraunhofer, the point of source and the screen is infinite distance from the aperture.
Okay, So this is the relation. This is the difference between the Fraunhofer diffraction and Fresnel type of diffraction. So actually, I am not discussing this topic today in detail because I can't complete it. So you can see this is the aperture. One lens is here. And here in this is the screen where we are getting the diffraction pattern. And see, this is the maximum point. This is maximum peak is here. Here different peaks you are getting, but the intensity is decreasing. Intensity is decreasing. So in this way, we will calculate. So the heavier calculation is there. So I will send you the note today. I'm not starting. Actually, it is already 10:45 and 5 minutes I can't complete. So I'm not starting this one today. So this is the different, you can see the different calculations are shown here. And ultimately, so this is heavier calculation. So just read it yourself today. And tomorrow I will start in detail. You have to first read it. Otherwise, you can't understand. So this is the formula that we are going to prove. I equal to I zero sine square beta by beta square. So this is the formula that we have to prove. So this is, you can see, this is a big calculation. So just you go through it. Every steps are given there. Again, I will discuss tomorrow. So different conditions. So this formula will prove tomorrow. And with certain conditions of maxima and minima, for maxima, this is principal maxima, this is secondary maxima. Secondary maxima, first secondary maxima, then again, second secondary maxima in this way, and these are different points of minima. This is one minima point, this is another minima point. Here it is pi, minus pi, then another minima at minus 2 pi, and here maxima equal to minus 3 by pi by 2, this is minus 5 pi by 2, and here it is a 0, this is a principal maxima. So these are different maxima, but this is principal and all are secondary. So the different conditions I will discuss in this way. So graphical method, this, and this is important very. The ratios are given for calculation, I0, I1, I2, I3. So this is I0, this is I0, this is the intensity here, I1, this is I2, this is I3 in this way. The relation between the intensities, it is shown here. 1 is to 1 by 22, is to 1 by 61, is to 1 by 121. So from here, you can see the intensity is increasing or decreasing.
Decreasing.
So I0 is maximum. Then I1 is less than I0. Then it is I2. It is less than I1. So in this way, you have to prove this. So different maxima points are here, but intensity gradually decreases in this direction. In both the direction of principal maxima. This is principal maxima. So we have to prove it. This is very important. The question is given. So this thing I will discuss tomorrow, but everything is given in this PPT note. So go through it. Go, just take your pen and paper, draw it, and then calculate yourself. Some mathematical calculations, no physics is here. So up to physics is up to the first part, then it is the mathematical calculation. E1 equal to this, E2 equal to this, E3 equal to this. Then we are taking the sum. Then next from this, totally mathematics. So these portions are totally mathematics and calculation. So I'm giving this note. I'm not starting this discussion because this is heavy calculation. So I can't finish it today. Okay, students. So tomorrow I will start this calculation. So I'm ending my class today. Okay. So whatever problems are given on laser, just calculate all that numerical problems. And Google form I will send you today. Fill up your phone number, father, mother, and yourself. Okay. And whatever I'm giving the note today of this diffraction first lecture. So read it very carefully before coming to my class tomorrow. Just read it very carefully, then you will understand. Otherwise, you will not understand. This is the big calculation. So just go through it, the whole note. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
And I want to ask another question that so actually my video lectures are given in the GIS site. So can you access that site? Have you your user ID and password?
Yes, ma'am.
So have you accessed that site? Every video lectures are given there. Have you seen?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So is it helpful for you? Because my video, all the classes, what is there, are given. So if you miss any class or anything, or if you want to again listen the video lecture, that means same thing, whatever I'm teaching here and also given there, same thing is given. So if you misses any class or if you want to hear it second time, then that will be helpful for you. Okay, so access that resources. And if you want to know the next, what is in your syllabus total, that is after optics. Next, I will start here, quantum mechanics, because I already told you that 5 lectures are given for optics. And do you know how many lectures are given in quantum mechanics? That is total 16 lectures are given in quantum mechanics. So I have to just then statistical mechanics is there. That is also very important. So it will take time. And in between that Maxwell's equation that I will discuss later. But before that, I will start quantum mechanics. Because it will take time, and then StatMac, and in between, if I get time, I will discuss those portions, magnetism, that is hysteresis loop, that is ferromagnetic material. Already, I think you know about that ferromagnetism, ferrimagnetism, diamagnetism. So if I think that if you get the note, you can read it yourself. So what are the difference and what is the definitions of the magnetic materials and the applications of the magnetic materials, these are. And one thing is new for you, that is dielectric. That dielectric portion I will discuss. So what is the dielectric material? What is the applications of the, what are the applications of the dielectric material? These are very important. So many things are left for discussing. So I have to be quick to complete my syllabus. So you could just go through the resources. That is, my video lectures are given there. So just go through it. And then that will help you for the coming classes. Okay, ending my class.
Ma'am?
Say?
We have a class test from 27 of Jan.
Yes?
Class test?
I don't know. I have no notice till now. So if there is test, then there will be. I will inform you tomorrow about this. Okay? So have you the notice of the class test from 27 Jan?
No notice, but Minit sir told us.
Okay, actually today one meeting is there in college. So after that meeting, it will be confirmed when will be the class test and how it will be conducted. So whatever information I will get, I will share it with you all tomorrow. Okay. So how the examination will be taken, the process, the questions, the chapters, what will be, that will be decided later. So decided today, and I will inform it tomorrow to all of you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you.